So I'm going to update the utility of S by looking at the utilities of all the other states, including itself, S prime, and weight those based on my probability of getting there, given that I took an action. And what action am I going to take? Well, I'm going to take the one that maximizes my expected utility.
So it's sort of like figuring out what to do in a state, assuming that this U hat really is the right answer for the future.
Right. Now, why is that going to work? So I just made up the U hats, right? They started out as arbitrary utilities. The next little step about updating utilities based on neighbors makes some sense because effectively a neighbor is any state that you can reach, which is determined by the transition function. But all I'm doing is reaching states that are also made up of arbitrary utilities, so arbitrary values. Why should that help me? Well, it's because of this value right here. This is actual truth. The actual reward that I get for entering into a state is a true value. So effectively what's going to happen is I'm going to be propagating out the true value or true reward, the true immediate reward that I get for entering into a state, say, through all of the states that I'm going to see and propagating that information back and forth until ultimately I converge.
Still not obvious why we should converge, because we start off with an arbitrary function and it seems like that could be really wrong. So we're like adding truth to wrong.
Yes, but then the next time around I've been adding truth twice to wrong. And then more truth to wrong and more truth to wrong. And eventually I'm going to be adding more and 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 more truth, and it will overwhelm the original wrong.
And does it help that the wrong is being discounted?
Yes, it helps that the wrong is being discounted. Does it help that the wrong is being discounted? I actually don't know that that matters. I have to think about that for a moment. It certainly doesn't hurt. But I guess the way that I think about this, I mean, there's an actual proof, you can look it up, but in the end, I tend to think of this as a kind of a simple contraction proof that effectively at every step, you have to be moving towards the answer because you've added in more of the reality, more of the truth. And if you remember, the utility of a state is just all the rewards that you're going to see. So basically at every time step, you've added the reward that you're going to see and then all the rewards you're going to see after that. And so you've gotten a better estimate of actually the sequence of rewards you're likely to see from a state. And if that gets better for any of the states, then eventually that betterness will propagate out to all the other states that they can reach or that can reach them. And that'll just keep happening and you'll keep getting closer and closer and closer for the true utility of the states until eventually you run out of closeness.
Cool.
Does that make sense at all?
Well, so does it also help that the gamma is less than one?
Yeah, it does. The way I like to think of this is as a sort of contraction proof, if you've heard of those. So the basic idea here is that you start out with some noise, but at every step, you're getting some truth. And that truth gets added, and then the next iteration, more truth gets added, and more truth gets added. So as you have some estimate of some particular state S, you get to update it based on truth, its actual reward, and you bring in more truth from the other utilities as well. As this particular utility gets better, that closeness to the true utility then gets spread to all the states that can reach it. And because the gamma is less than one, you basically get to overwhelm the past, in this case, which is the original arbitrary utilities. And so as you keep iterating through this, the latest truth becomes more important than the past less truth. And so you're always getting closer and closer and closer to the truth until eventually you do. At least that's the intuition that I like to think of.
Yeah, I kind of get that as an intuition, though I'd probably be happier going through the math. But
well, we could do that. And by we, I mean the students can do that by actually reading the proof.
All right.
Okay, so cool. So this right here is an easy way to find the true value of states. And you do it by iterating. And it kind of has a name.
It kind of has a name.
Yeah, what do you think the name
is? Bellman. Bellman's algorithm.
No, though that's probably reasonable.
Utility iteration.
Yes, except utility sounds better if you say value. So it's value iteration. And it works remarkably well.
So, and it doesn't give you the answer, but it gets you something that's closer and closer to the answer.
Right, and eventually it'll converge or get so close to converging it doesn't matter. And once you have the true utilities, if you recall, we know how to define the optimal policy in terms of the utilities. So if I give you the utilities, then the optimal policy is just, well, I'm in a state. Look at all the states I might get to. Figure out the expectation that I'm going to get for a given action, pick whichever one is maximal, and I'm done. So solving for the utilities or the true value of a state is effectively the same thing as solving for the optimal policy.
Hmm.
Excellent.
That's cool.
I think so.